everyone. This is Reverend Dr. Rebecca Michael, and this is a WWJD Leadership Series. And today I would like to talk briefly about setting goals and what this has to do with Jesus and his disciples. Now, basically, if you go to the last video on types of leaders, visionaries, and managers, I'm not going to repeat that, but the way Jesus lived and the way he educated his disciples, with the way he disciple means students, so the way he taught them was to become Christ-like, like him, with their own personality, but with his traits and his leadership traits, such as visionary and managerial. These are just words to sort of help us with getting a definition, because words are for defining things and naming things and labeling things, and they're important. And so if you want to go to that video and watch that one. Now, Jesus and his disciples, they lived a very healthy, wholesome lifestyle. They were on the straight and narrow, very active. They went the hero route, deny yourself, take up your cross and follow me, Jesus said. And leave everything. Be prepared to leave home, family, everything. If you're called out by the Holy Spirit to do that, because the family is holding you back or oppressive or whatever, God will call you away. I'm not talking about dependence now, children. I'm talking about, or husbands and wives, God forbid. But I'm talking about family in the larger sense, in terms of what we're born into, because there's just two kingdoms, and there's the one that we were born into by default, and when we come into the kingdom of God, our souls have been saved and regenerated by Jesus Christ. We now have a new king, and we belong to a new kingdom, and that is our family, and our new family. And we continue to intercede and pray for the family that we were born into, that they might be born again too and become a family of God over here. But, you know, sometimes he calls us away. He called the disciples away, for example. Many of them left homes and left. They just left when he said to leave. That's it. Leave your people and your father's house. That was it. They left. And walking the talk on the straight and narrow, it's not easy, but it's the healthy, disciplined life. In the end, it leads to liberty. So it could feel that you're restricting yourself in some ways or refraining from, but that's short term. Long term, the benefits, it's just like a training plan has health benefits at the end of it, rather than addiction and destruction of relationships, etc. That is the free, licentious way. But that's a counterfeit of freedom. That's not true freedom, because that sacrifices others and sacrifices relationships, etc. It's oppressive, persecuting, etc. It's self-serving, basically. But when we're in the kingdom of God, we're led by His Spirit and empowered by His Spirit now to be truly loyal in service in agape love. And so what does this have to do with setting goals? Well, it has to do with being focused on your mission. And I talked a little bit about the mission last time when I read Luke 4:18 in the types of leaders video I just did. And so setting goals, you want to set long and short-term goals, for example. Jesus was very goal-oriented on the will of the Father. And I have other videos like Becoming Who You're Meant to Be that discuss how you can determine the providence of God in your life and the calling of God, and how you can come into that calling. And just like he had a scripture of his mission, then you can define your mission. For example, mine, at least at this time, is to champion in this ministry, to champion others, first having overcome myself and then being able, more like a role model in the organization, that we have various aspects of health and fitness, mental health, every form there is to lead to the abundant life that we're called to in the Lord, in order that we might serve out of abundance and be fruitful and productive people in the kingdom of God without this actually being something that we're doing out of a driven state, but rather being led by the Holy Spirit. So we have the energy to do that if we have the energy reserves. So this is why how we live in a disciplined, healthy way in the short term, in the long term, leads to incredible benefits. I liken it to a training program. And so I have a couple of minutes here. I was just going to discuss, like, for example, nursing care plans. We used to do nursing care plans when I was in mental health. And for example, you identify a need and then you restate it in the positive. And so this is a way you can do for yourself for setting goals, for example. You can identify a need in yourself. For example, in nursing, if you say a patient is dehydrated, rather than say that, you restate it in the positive in the need state so that it's easily identified the solution. Patient needs hydration. Now, when it gets more complicated, that seems simple, but when it gets more complicated, you'll see the wisdom to putting that in the positive way. And then you come up with plans of actions, which is the short-term goal. So the long-term goal is the need area, or what your desire is. For example, if it's a fitness plan, I did a video. You might want to go to Dad Kicking Buttcast, where I did a video called Personal Fitness Plans. How to make one. And so I go into a little more detail on that one. But there's four areas of personal fitness, for example. Body composition, aerobic, cardiovascular fitness, the second area, the third area is flexibility, and the fourth is weight training or muscular fitness or whatever you want to, however you want to put that. And so in those four areas, you can develop short-term goals for yourself in all of those four areas by identifying the long-term goal, the need, for example, body composition, fat to muscle content, finding out what is the proper range for you, for your age, for your height, etc. And you can find that in introductory textbooks on health and... Sorry, it freezes from time to time, but health and fitness textbooks are great. Say you go to any college and make up a plan. But you can go to that video and watch that one. I've got a video on how to draw up a fitness plan so that you have vital reserves in order that you're doing what it is you're called to do in the mission of this life, once you identify that. And if you go to that other video I told you about, becoming all you're meant to be, I believe it's in my mental health counseling playlist. Well, then that'll give you some ideas there to do with how you tell what your providence is, etc., your calling. So the nursing care plan, just getting back to that briefly, is you may come up with four plans of action. For example, patient needs hydration. That's the need, restated positively. And then you may come up with four plans of action to rehydrate someone, or rehydrate yourself, whatever. For example, drinking more water at fluids or at meals, drinking between snacks, some more fluids, eating fruit because fruit's got actual water content in it, drinking decaffeinated beverages is the fourth area. You might want to reduce that instead of and drink actually uncaffeinated products because caffeine is a diuretic, and so that dehydrates you. I just wanted to mention one more thing about Jesus here. Once again, he's our King. And so if you look at him, he was focused on his mission, the will of the Father. And if you read again Luke 4:18, you'll see that he was very focused on that in his ministry. So when you read the Gospels, you understand what he's doing. He's going through with his plan. He set long and short-term goals for doing that. And you can infer that by the way he lived. He came here for atonement, mediation, restoration, and resurrection to give us eternal life. And so it did freeze, but hopefully this goes through, and see you in about 2 weeks. God bless you.